Hello, it's me again. Welcome back to The Walking Dead. So we're just about to head up into Crawford. That's what we're doing. We're going up here. Let's just get right to it, honestly.
Let's go.
Is everybody? There should be guards patrolling.
What? Are you disappointed?
It's just strange, is all.
I think I see one over there by the door.
Okay. Me and Kitty will sneak out, try to take him out quiet. The rest of you wait for our signal, then follow us over. Everybody got it? Okay, Kitty, let's do this quiet. No shooting unless there's no other choice.
Right behind you.
That's bad.
What the fuck is a walker doing inside here? Get inside, fast!
Saw us.
Definitely.
What the hell happened here? I thought this place was supposed to be secure.
What always happens, I guess. In the end, the dead always win.
Oh man, we are so screwed.
No, this is good.
Vernon's right. We can deal with walkers easier than armed guards.
I agree. So long as we don't let them box us in, we can still do this. The plan hasn't changed. The plan hasn't changed? Changes.
Sorry, that was weird.
Any idea how many of them are out there?
No. You want to do a head count? Or do you want to get what we need and get the hell out of here? Come on. I think I know which way to head.
I got a bad feeling about this.
I mean, you shouldn't feel good about it, but just chill. Stick together. Panicking will only make things worse.
Just keep moving.
Here.
Looks okay. Everybody in.
Looks like they were using this room as some kind of command center.
Okay, so now what? Where do we start looking?
Here. Just give me a sec.
could find a battery?
Maybe at the auto shop. There used to be one in the alley outside the fire escape.
Yep, it's called Herman's. You can't miss it.
Where can we find some fuel for the boat?
There's a maintenance shed across from the playground here. If they were storing fuel, that's probably where it'll be. What about the medicine?
Right here. Nurse's station. They were using it as a medical facility.
How do you know that?
Just makes sense, doesn't it?
Okay. Whoops. I'll make the run to the maintenance shed for the fuel.
Giving way too much of your tragic backstory.
I can take you right to it.
I'll come too. No, two people's enough. You stay here, see if you can use any of those tools we brought to get that armory door open. We might need to shoot our way out of here.
I'll go for the medicine.
I'll come with you. I know what to take.
Okay. Guess that leaves me to go find us a battery.
I'll go with you. Watch your back.
Okay, we've got a plan. Everyone be careful. Stay close to one another. We'll all meet back here. Good luck.
What about me? What can I do?
I need you to stay here with Ben and watch over our command center. I'm putting you in charge of it, okay?
You're leaving me with Ben?
I'm not leaving you with Ben. I'm leaving him with you. Understand?
Oh, okay.
Back before you know.
Okay, let's check this place out a little bit.
Nothing but crayons and construction paper. So according to Bree, fuel's at the maintenance shed. Medicine might be at the nurse's office. And a battery would probably be at the auto shop out through here.
Let's go.
Fuel's in a shed across from the playground. It's just outside the stairwell. If we're gonna find medicine anywhere, that would be the place to look. Bree said the entrance to the auto shop was in the alleyway by this fire escape. The Georgia State flag. A lot of history there. Not that it matters much now, I guess. Hopscotch.
Maybe Clem can play.
Creepy. Might come back for these later. Any reading material would be nice once we get on that boat.
That's a good point.
Hey, you need any help with that?
Thanks, I got it. Just once, I'd like to do something useful, you know?
You're plenty useful.
Yeah, right. Seems like all I ever do is get us into trouble.
Well, I'll let you get on with it.
Get on with getting us into trouble.
There is something you can help me with. Something that's been on my mind. I could use your opinion.
What is it?
It's Kenny. Since I've been helping him work on the boat, I've gotten to know him a little better. He's a good guy, you know? And it's eating me up knowing what I know. I've been thinking about telling him the truth.
Come on. This again?
It's my fault Doc and Katja got killed. If I hadn't screwed up back at the motor inn, they'd still be alive. How am I supposed to just carry something like that around? I have to tell him.
Whoops.
I guess you've got your own problems. Look, don't worry about it. I'll figure it out. I'm gonna get back to this.
I don't even really know what to say to him anyways, well, like...
No TV.
Like, Jesus, Ben. Can I try this?
How are things going with that door?
Slowly but surely.
Okay.
Looks like they had quite a system here. Crawford's final solution.
Oh, oops. Sorry. Hey, girl.
You okay, Clem?
Yeah. This desk is just like the ones we have in my school. I know it's weird, but I kind of miss it, being in school.
Me too. I used to be a teacher, remember? Tell you what, when we find ourselves a safe place, set up a little classroom, just you and me.
Will there be homework?
No homework.
Do you think things will ever be normal again? Just like the way they were before?
No.
I don't think anyone knows the answer to that, Clem. Maybe there's somebody out there working on a way to fix this. Some kind of cure, maybe. There's just no way to know.
I hope so.
That's good. You hold on to that hope. It's the one thing none of this can take away.
I mean, I would argue that this situation does take away your hope after a bit.
What's going on in the rest of the world? Just a bunch of paste.
Alright. Alright, let's get going. I want to read this. All illnesses and medical conditions must be disclosed to the council. Children under 14 not admitted without authorization. Can I please do this? Anyone asked to leave Crawford cannot return under any circumstances. Theft or looting within the district not tolerated. Waste not. Whatever. Good enough.
Must
leader.
Be the guy who ran this place. Looks like he figured himself as some kind of supreme leader.
Alleyway to the auto shops down here. You coming or not?
Yeah, I'll go with you. Let's go there first. Let's look at the spent shell casings.
Shell casings all over. Whatever happened here wasn't good.
Can I take them?
I've already been fired. They're worthless. Must be the door to the alleyway where the auto shop is. Where the hell is Molly?
She was just here.
Molly, you out here? Guess I'm not going that way. That must be down this way.
Uh-oh. I want my back to a wall, thank you. Alright, maybe I do have to go through that little house. Ah, here we go.
must be the entrance to that auto shop where Bree said we'd find that battery. Damn, it's jammed tight.
Sure, it'd be nice if Molly was here to help out.
Better not get too close.
Oh.
Leave him! He's mine.
What were you doing up there? Molly? Molly!
What?
I think you got it.
One more!
He's wearing medical scrubs. Some kind of scientist or doctor, maybe?
Yeah, well, he ain't shit now. Did you find us a way in?
Yeah, but the garage door's jammed. Can't raise it.
Not a problem. Look what I found.
Oh yeah, that'll work.
It's gotta work fast.
Come on.
Awesome.
Take a look around. I'll make sure no stragglers get under this door.
Well, I can see where the battery should be, but it's not.
Perfect.
Blinking. Must be an anti-theft system. Good chance of a working battery being in that car. If I can find a way to get up there. It's the panel that controls the hydraulic lift over there. It looks like it's the hose for the lift hydraulics. Law of Crawford's rules. How did anybody live like this? I'd rather take my chances on the outside.
Why can't I use... No power, I guess. Can't lower the car. Oh, excuse me. I just yawned.
Something you need?
What do you think happened to Crawford?
Don't know, don't care. As far as I'm concerned, these fuckers got what was coming to them.
Not a lot of sympathy for all the people who died here, huh?
I have about as much for them as they did for the sick and the old and anyone else they didn't think was fit to belong in their little paradise. So yeah, fuck them.
Yeah?
What was all that about back there?
He came at me up on that rooftop, tried to take a bite out of me, so I took care of business. What, you got a problem with me killing geeks?
No, it just seemed like you went to town on him a little more than you needed to.
Hey, you never really know when those things are all the way dead. I was just making sure. Look, you want to get this battery or not? Time's wasting.
Think I can borrow that, hook thing of yours?
I don't know. Hilda and I have been through a lot together.
Hilda?
That's what I call her. Don't judge.
Please, can I borrow Hilda? I'll take good care of her. She won't get a scratch.
I got your promise now. Not a scratch.
All right.
can't reach it up there. I did it.
There we go.
Whoa, whoa!
That's probably not good.
No shit!
I'll try to hold them off. Hurry!
There's the battery. Finally, something goes right. Still attached to the terminals.
Come on.
Got that one off. It's off. Got it.
Yeah, but we still got a problem here. Put it in here. I'll carry it. Okay, follow me. Move your ass!
Where's my ass going?
Great, now what?
Skylight.
It's shut.
Shoot it out! Never stop complaining. Come on.
Gosh, she's so cool.
Come on, what are you, chicken? Jump.
What did you call me?
Well, now that you mention it.
Yeah. Back inside. Mission accomplished.
Come on.
Later. Something I gotta do first.
What?
Catch you later.
Wait, you've still got the battery.
Yeah, I think I'll hold on to it. Make sure you don't leave without me. See you back in class.
Molly! Damn it, what the hell is she doing?
Being cool.
You guys need any help?
Thanks, but I think we're almost in.
We're taking care of it, Lee. Don't worry.
You sure you two don't need any help?
We're taking care of it, Lee. Don't worry.
Alright, alright. One less bullshit I gotta deal with. But I need to go get the fuel. Which was this way, I guess? That's
little
bad.
Little help here!
Ah! 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 Wrong button, wrong button, wrong button. Nice.
Let's not start high-fiving each other just yet. Let's get the hell back to the classroom. Give us a hand with these fuel cans. They weigh a goddamn ton.
Yep.
You're back.
Yeah. We made out pretty good, too.
Great work, Kenny.
How you doing with that door?
Not so good.
Here,
Let me give you a hand. Did you get that battery yet?
Yeah, Molly has it. She should be back here soon.
She'd better be.
Bree?
Hey, Lee. Thanks for all your help back there. I don't think we would have made it without you.
Nope.
No problem. We're all on the same team. So you're a cancer survivor, like Vernon and the others.
Yeah, I was diagnosed when I was in college. Been getting treatment ever since. Just when I was starting to get better, I thought there might be some hope. All this happened. Lost my whole family. I'm the only one who survived. Funny how things work out, huh?
That's not funny, but okay.
How long have you known Vernon?
Couple of years. He ran our support group. He was really great, helping me come to terms with my disease. But how do you come to terms with something like this? With a place like Crawford? I don't know what I or the other survivors would have done without Vernon. He's the one who held us together, kept us alive.
What do you think about this whole Crawford situation?
I'd rather not talk about it. Too many awful memories. Even being back here gives me a bad feeling.
Even now, with everyone dead?
I got no sympathy for what happened to these people. They weeded out the sick and the old. Even children. Those least able to defend themselves so that they could save their own skins. Whatever happened here, however Crawford fell, I consider it poetic justice.
Damn, girl, that's cold.
That's how nope. I feel. If you'd seen what I seen, you'd feel the same.
Totally fair.
I'm a little busy here, Lee. Maybe you should go get that battery or help with the medicine.
I'm gonna go check out the boys in the door.
What do we still need?
We already got the fuel and the battery. Once we find some medicine, we'll be good to go.
So where's this battery you found?
Molly has it. She ran off to do something.
Well, she'd better bring it back here. I don't know why you trusted that girl with it. We hardly know her.
She saved your life, didn't she?
Yeah, but what has she done for me lately?
Jesus Christ, Kenny. There was really no choice but to give it to her? She's the one with the backpack.
Yeah. Where's Molly?
She had to go run an errand. She'll be back soon.
I hope she's okay.
She'll be fine. She's pretty tough. Just sit tight, okay? I need to go take care of a few things.
Alright.
Alright, let's go. See if they need help with the medicine, I guess? We're just gonna pretend that that's not happening. Speed walk away. Oh!
Mr. Vernon must be trapped in there.
Yep. Nice. I'm good at shooting.
What the hell happened?
They wandered into the hallway after we got inside. I think they must have heard us rooting around in here. The whole place is infested. They're everywhere.
Calm down. I took care of them. What about the meds? Did we find what we need?
Yeah, that's our other problem. Take a look.
Oh, it's empty, isn't it?
Looks like they were keeping all the prescription meds in that safe, locked up tight.
Can we just guess the combination?
It's a 4-digit code. You do the math.
Well, I doubt they just wrote it down and left it here for us to find. We should just try busting it open. We don't have any other choice.
Okay, you get started. I'll take a look around, see if I can find anything useful. What's this on the floor?
It's a sonogram.
Y'all already checked these drawers?
Yes, Lee. Nothing in there worth taking.
There's dried blood on this printer. And on the floor. Looks like a trail of it from the safe to the camera over there. Then out the door. What the hell happened here?
A bad thing. I'm gonna guess a really bad thing.
No tape inside.
Shit.
The way this camera's set up, it looks like it would have had a pretty good view of that keypad. I wonder if it caught someone punching it in. I'll have to take time to rest later, I think. What is this? A copy machine. Not that it matters with no power around. Just a bunch of papers. No safe combination, though. Phone's probably haven't worked in months. Looks like some kind of medical file. Anna Correa. She must have been a patient here. What's this? I think maybe we just got lucky.
That'd be a first.
How's it coming?
Slow. Too slow. I'm worried that by the time we manage to get this thing open, it may be too late.
Molly helped me get the battery we needed.
That's great. One down. Where is she?
She took off. Had some kind of errand she needed to run.
Took off? With the battery?
Yeah. Don't worry. She'll be back.
I hope so. That girl doesn't really strike me as a team player. More the mercenary.
How much time do you think Omid has, Doc?
You want my medical opinion? The sooner we get him some strong antibiotics to start fighting that infection, the better. Let's just leave it at that, huh?
Hey, Doctor. I just wanted to thank you for coming with us. And for all your help. I really appreciate it.
Don't mention it. It's times like these we've got to help each other the most, right? And we're no better than those Crawford sons of bitches.
I heard that. I'll go see if I can find something that'll help us get that safe open.
Good idea.
Okay. I don't need to look at the clock. Oops.
New tape. Figures.
The tape's gotta be around here somewhere. Keep looking.
Vernon, Krista, come look at this.
This is day 82 since the outbreak. 1547, Dr. Logan in consultation with patient Anna Correa.
Why are you recording this?
Regulations.
Oh, it's the guy Molly killed.
All medical examinations and consultations. I need you to brace yourself, Anna. The sonogram confirms that you're pregnant.
Oh, God.
As you know, the rules are very clear. The termination is mandatory.
You don't have to tell them. Tell them it was just nausea. But you gave me something for it and it went away. This is my problem, not yours.
If Overson finds out that I concealed evidence of a pregnancy, I'm sorry, but these are the rules. I'm gonna give you a sedative. It'll make the procedure easier on you.
I don't want the procedure. I want my baby. I can't do this.
Anna, you don't have a choice. Now, if you like, you can take some time with this. But I need you to come back no later than tomorrow, or I'll have no choice but to inform Overson myself. I'm sorry.
Damn it! We almost had it.
What the hell kind of place was this?
Like Molly said, the worst kind.
Lee, maybe there's another tape. We gotta keep looking.
I think I recognize that doctor. He was one of the walkers out in the alley by the auto shop.
Maybe you should search him. See what he's got on him.
Great. fucking waiting for that. Cool. Kind of weird he's not dead after all that beating, but he's a zombo.
This is definitely the guy. This might be just what we need. What's this? Looks like some kind of code. But Vernon said the safe combination was only four numbers. Shit, time to go.
Time to slow walk all the way back.
Found another tape. This one's dated October 10th.
That's the day after the first one we watched.
Put it in.
Have you made a decision?
I thought you said I didn't have a choice.
Well, technically you do. You can terminate the pregnancy or leave Crawford. Of course, that would be a death sentence for both you and your unborn child.
Maybe that's best. I stayed up all last night thinking about this. Why are we even trying to survive? To keep on living, if this is what it takes. If this is what it's turned us into.
I don't make the rules, Anna.
Doctor, I'm begging you. Please, help me.
Maybe one day, when things are different, you can try again. But for now, today, we have to do this. We know what happened to Crawford.
More importantly, we got the combination.
Krista, are you all right? What's wrong?
It's nothing. That was just hard to watch. Don't worry about me. I'm fine.
All right. Let's get those meds and get the hell out of here.
We're in business. Antibiotics, morphine. We'll take as much of this as we can carry. Okay, I think we're good. This is more than enough for your people and mine. Let's go.
You go on ahead. I want to make sure we didn't miss anything. I'll be right behind you.
Don't take too long.
Vernon and Krista already took everything we need.
Just take stuff you don't need to, just in case. There she is.
Oh, you scared the shit out of me. Where the fuck have you been?
Sightseeing.
I'll take that battery down.
Oh, yeah. About that.
What?
I'm just kidding. Here you go.
What's that?
Nothing.
Sure there's nothing you want to tell me?
Yeah, I'm sure. Are we done? What the hell?
I think that's our cue to get the hell out of here.
Jesus!
Chip! Sorry. I just got spooked by those bells, and then I heard someone coming.
Did you leave Clementine alone?
No, Kenny's with her. We still can't open that armory door. He sent me out to look for something we can use to bust it open. I found this.
Ben? Where did you get that?
I just found it. It was stuck in the door handle at the end of the hallway back there.
Oh, no.
Chip!
Thank you.
Thanks.
That was not me.
It wasn't me.
Keep going, kid. Nice shot.
Holy shit. Good job, Clem.
What the fuck is going on?
They're coming.
Oh, shit.
That ought to hold them.
Sir, but now how do we get out?
Through the armory. We can just get this damn door open.
Come on, damn you!
This is my fault, all my fault. What
the hell's he babbling about?
Ben, we talked about this.
No, wait. I want to know what he meant. What do you mean this is all your fault?
Penny, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, man. Kid, this ain't the best time. Whatever you did, save it for later.
Ben, we don't have time for this now.
I'm sorry, Lee. I can't do this anymore. He's got a right to know.
Know what?
It's been me all along, putting all of us in danger. Katja and Duck, it was all me. It was all me.
Wait a minute. What are you saying?
It was me who made the deal with the bandits at the motor inn, slipping them supplies. I thought maybe I could keep them off our backs. When it got discovered, that's when they attacked. And that's when Duck...
Kitty, man. I agree with you. You should kick his ass. But now's not the time. Gotta focus on getting out of here.
You little pissant! You're fucking dead, you hear me? Dead! My wife and child! You got a boat fucking killed!
Kitty, listen to me. You can whip his skinny little ass later. But right now, we gotta go!
Nice group you got here.
Not the time, Molly.
If this asshole thinks he's getting on my boat after what he did, he's out of his motherfucking mind! You hear me, shitbird? You can stay behind and fucking rot!
Kenny, we'll sort this out later, after we get out of here, okay?
Ain't nothing to sort out. I just told you the way it's gonna be. The boat's not big enough for all of us. Somebody's gotta get left behind. Might as well be this piece of shit right here!
Well, I vote we leave him. I'm sorry, Ben. I know you mean well. But all I want to do is get back to Omi, and you put that at risk.
Wait, don't I get a vote?
Of course you do.
Ben's nice. He's my friend. We don't leave friends behind. That's my vote.
On second thought, I think I'm gonna abstain. Okay?
I can't do this right now. I abstain. We'll figure this out later.
What about the rest of us? Don't we get a say?
Don't matter anymore.
Now can we go?
Damn right. Vernon, come on! So much for the armory.
What's left of it?
A few rounds. That's it.
Fuck.
You didn't close that door behind us?
I couldn't. The lock was busted.
Great. Just fucking great. Come on. There's gotta be a way out down here.
Nope.
Fuck!
That's not gonna hold. Back upstairs!
Lee, look!
Check what's in it. Check what's in it. Okay. Yes. How many fucking bullets is in this shotgun? Wow, 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 wow. Ah! Oh my God. Okay. Walker. Leg. Leg. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Krista. Nice.
Come on!
It's all right, Clint. I'm fine. Any way out of here?
This leads to the roof. We might be able to find a way down from there.
You didn't come into town from the railroad, did you?
Yeah. Why?
Never mind. I can see the sewer where we came in from here. I think we can do this.
Well, what are we waiting for? Go, go!
Come on, let's go!
Oh my God. He's just a kid.
We both know. Let me go.
The least I could have done was shot him. But like, he doesn't make it anyways, because your choices don't actually matter in this game, so like,
Krista, don't! Stay back!
I never should have left you. I'm so sorry.
Krista, get away from him.
Hey. Back already?
We got you medicine.
Good. I feel like I could use some. Where's Ben?
He didn't make it.
What happened?
Dumb son of a bitch nearly got us all killed. Lee stepped up and did what he had to.
That's not what happened. That's not what happened.
Nice going, asshole.
What's eating you?
Yeah, I did what I had to. But I don't expect Clementine to understand that. Hell, I don't want her to understand it.
You did the right thing. Trust me. She'll understand. I'm gonna go start work on the boat.
Okay, with a little luck, you should start feeling better pretty soon. I'll stay here for a few more hours to check on her. Let me know if you need anything.
Thanks, Doc.
Yes, thank you so much.
Maybe now's a good time for you and me to have a little talk in private.
Yep.
About what happened to Bree.
Don't beat yourself up over it. There was nothing you could have done. You want to know the worst part?
What?
I don't feel much. I mean, I don't feel enough. Shouldn't I be broken up over what happened to her? That's how I was when I lost my daughter. When I lost my friends in those first few weeks. But now, it's like I just take something like this in stride. Like this is what our world is now. Better just get used to it.
What did you want to talk to me about?
I know you care about Clementine. Anyone can see that. And I know you want what's best for her. But this plan of yours, putting everyone on a boat with no destination, do you really think that's her best chance of finding somewhere where she can be safe? Because I don't. So I want to make you an offer.
What kind of an offer?
I'll take her off your hands. Take her back with me, to my people. We're well supplied, well hidden, and a lot of us have had kids of our own. And now Crawford's fallen, we got nothing left to fear from them. She'll be safe with us. Safer than she will be if she stays with you, I promise. That's what you want for her, isn't it? Be safe?
I didn't mean that option, but...
I know it's a lot to consider, but I want you
That's
to think
okay.
about some things. You chose to let that boy die back in Crawford. I gotta wonder about the morality of the kind of man who would do something like that. I got to wonder what kind of parent you'd be.
This is not a normal situation, and... He... Like, we... He didn't want... I hate this? I don't like making people upset. I have made several people upset.
Going somewhere?
Yeah, I'm about to head out. I just wanted to say thanks. For everything. It's been fun.
What are you talking about? Kenny's working on the boat right now. Thought you were coming with us. God knows you earned it.
Yeah, I've been thinking it over. It's not for me. Sounds like it'd be pretty crowded, and I never did like the water.
You sure about this?
I'm sure. I've always done better on my own, anyhow. Listen, I'm not much for goodbyes. Tell the others for me?
Sure. You take care of yourself, Mom.
You too, Lee. And you be sure to take care of that little girl. You know she thinks the world of you.
I know.
Good luck.
Ain't nothing to do with luck.
Hey,
Danny's working on the boat.
I know.
What are we going to do after he fixes it? Where will we go?
Someplace else. Someplace better. Clem, honey, what's wrong?
What happened to Ben? What did Kenny mean when he said you did what you had to?
Clem, you have to believe me. I tried to save him, but Ben didn't want me to.
What do you mean?
What Ben did was very brave. He knew we were running out of time, and that saving him might put everyone else in danger. So he told me to leave him behind so the rest of us could get away. I know that's difficult to understand.
I understand.
You do?
Yeah. He thought about other people before he thought about himself. My mom always told me that's what makes a good person.
Well, she was right.
Before we leave tomorrow, will we have time to look for my parents?
I'd like to, Claire, but I don't think we'll have time. We really shouldn't stay here any longer. It's not safe.
I'm sorry, honey. With the state of this town, I really don't think you'd want to find them anyways.
Clementine? Clementine?
Where'd she go?
Clementine!
Bum, bum, bum. Make sure there's nothing behind there. Oh, of course there was. Whoops.
Are you crazy? What are you doing out here? It ain't safe. You
gotta tell him.
Lee? Where's Clementine? She's not in her room.
Vernon ain't in the house either. What the hell is going on?
Whose blood is that?
It's mine.
Oh my god.
No way.
No. No fucking way.
There's no time to worry about me. Clementine's gone.
There's no chance she just wandered off on her own? Then who the hell took her?
I don't know. Last night, Vernon came to me and offered to take her with him. Said she'd be better off.
Son of a bitch. I knew we couldn't trust that fucker.
Wherever she is, I have to find her.
Okay. What do you need from us?
Clem may not have much time. We have a better chance of finding her if we all go together. Who's with me?
We're all responsible for Clementine. And in your condition, we may not make it to her in time. She needs our help. All of our help.
Damn,
this
right.
is what happens when you make friends with everyone. I think.
So that's settled then. We'll look for Clementine together.
Thanks, you guys. I appreciate it.
I don't know if Omid should really be up in Adam only the day after getting his medication, though. Realistically, his infection is not gone.
You've always been there for me, Lee. Always had my back when it mattered. What kind of friend would I be if I wasn't there for you now?
Hell yeah!
Bitten or not, I'm with you to the end. You can count on me.
Okay, guys, we should go find
the end of the line.
Let's head out.
What about the boat? We just gonna leave it unguarded?
If someone was gonna take it, they'd have done it already. Besides, what choice do we have?
Somehow unsurprising.
Where the hell are they?
Looks like they got out of here in a hurry.
Vernon, get out here! There doesn't have to be any trouble here. All I want is the girl. Give her back and nobody needs to get hurt.
That sounds bad.
Son of a bitch!
Tony!
Where have you taken her?
This isn't Vernon. And you should really watch your tone.
Clementine's fine. But if I were you, I'd choose my next words very carefully.
Bum, bum, bum. Okay, let's see. So, most of us killed the boy in the attic. Most of us were rational and honest to Vernon. Most of us brought Clementine. I am the minority in letting Ben fall. And most of us showed everyone the bite. Good. Oh, okay, I guess it looks like you do bring Ben with you if he don't die. Most people just go with Kenny. What the hell? Interesting. Interesting. Well, anyways, thank you guys so much for watching yet another episode of The Walking Dead. The next one is the last episode of this season, which will be very exciting. Kind of wrap up this story arc. I mean, we all know what happens. We're all preparing for it. If you don't know what happens at the end of season one, then you are in for a treat, let me fucking tell you, over the next couple of weeks or so. Thank you so much for sticking with me this whole time. It has been really great. This episode was a little bit quieter, but I decided to record it as soon as I woke up, which was maybe a bit of a mistake. So my voice was a little not present for some of the times, and also it's a little bit more of a serious episode, so hopefully it was all good in that respect. All good in the hood. In the neighborhood. Anyways, before I can ramble on too much, I hope you guys have a wonderful week, have a wonderful time, have a wonderful Easter. It's Easter today. Happy Easter. But thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Goodbye!